I'm really falling for you. I think I'm two nights in a row with that song, three nights in a row with that song. What's up, Mouth Pager? Shabbat Shalom. Wow. Is it Shabbat service? It's not Shabbat service. This is a special edition of Mouth Page. All kinds of requests today. There's a lot of lot going on with just everything, and I've had a lot of my friends, a lot of people said, hey, Rabbi Oyak, we need a special thing for you tonight. Do something for us tonight. So I said, all right. So without further ado, Shabbat Shalom. But since it's Shabbat, I got to honor Shabbat first because, you know, God is always important. So let's do a quick light the candle. I know it's a special edition, right? So light the candle. First, if you've got a candle, you light it. Do-do-do. And traditionally, you cover your eyes and you say, Baruch atah Adonai, Elohim HaMelechim, Asher Kidshanu B'Mitzvotav V'Tzivanu L'Halit Nir Shel Shabbat. Blessed are you, Lord our God, ruler of the universe, who blesses, kindles the light of Shabbat. Wow, it's Shabbat. Shalom, Mouth Pages. Okay, so I know I'm going to do a special edition of what we normally do on our weekday motivations on a Shabbat day. So crazy. I know all kinds of Jews are probably like, ooh, what's going on? But this is important. All my friends say this is important. So without further ado, we've been going live now for a little over 2 years, and we're over 176,000. We just surpassed 175,000. We're at 176,000 diehard Mouth Pagers liking us and following us on Facebook. That is amazing, Mouth Pagers. That is crazy. So thank you all so much. We are growing. This year's our year. We're going to do it. Let's go over 200,000. We need to do this, Mouth Pagers. We need to make a stand, and we need to make a stand now. So I Don't Think So is going to be the name of our topic tonight. Oh, we got to do a little blessing. Sorry. Declaration of faith in one God. Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Baruch Shem Kavod, Malchuto L'Olam Ve'ed. Hear Israel, Adonai is our God. Adonai is one. Blessed be the name of his glorious kingdom forever and ever. Amen. Amen. So I Don't Think So is the name of our topic. So what does that mean? Why are we talking about this? So I had a friend say, hey, today, Yak, we it's just a lot is going on. You watch the TV, watch the news. See, for me, I know it's material like a comedian, you should always have stuff to watch, but see, I don't want cable no more. I'm sick and tired of watching the nonsense. I can't do it no more. It's too brainwashy for me. I just can't do it. I'm too close to God. I'm just too involved with God, and I'm free. I just don't want to be poisoned anymore. That you call it like it is, you can be mad, but it's my opinion. I don't want to do it no more. But I have friends that watch and are like, hey, there's a lot going on with just this, that, and the other. So we want to do a special. So I Don't Think So is the name of our topic tonight. What does that mean? I Don't Think So. So I hear a lot of people talking about God in a negative way. Well, God doesn't exist. God doesn't this. God's not that. Well, I Don't Think So. I don't think you're right. I Don't Think So. See, when I say I Don't Think So, I'm saying I don't think so. I don't think so. I don't think you're right. I don't think so. I don't think you're right. I don't think so. Because you're not right. God does exist. I don't think you've been properly educated. See, here's what I'm talking about. So it's kind of like a shell. I don't think so. I don't think so. See, that should be like the name. But the caveat of what I'm talking about, because everybody's over here is going, what? What are you talking about? Okay, so when people say you can't talk about God anymore, you can't talk about God in school, or you can't say the Pledge of Allegiance, I don't think so. I don't think I'm going to follow that rule. I don't think I'm going to listen to it. I don't think I'm going to abide by it. I'm not. Because here's the thing. The Ten Commandments. We missed it. We missed the boat. We've thrown it out the window. We forgot about what it means. We don't even care anymore, it seems like. So we got to bring it back. We got to bring it back old school. Ten Commandments. Let's do the parable first. I am the Lord thy God who brought you out of the land of Egypt to be your God. Here we go. Number one, you should have no other gods before me. You should not worship false gods, false idols. So one and two. You have no other gods before me. You shouldn't be worshiping nobody else. So right there tells you that whatever you watch on TV or what do you hear on the radio, that should just be entertainment at best. So anybody that tells you other than that, say, I don't think so. At best, entertainment. At best. Or comic relief. At best. Other than that, it's I don't think so. You should not worship false gods, false idols. Right there. Number two. At best. Any other things should just be entertainment. You want to buy a car? Great. You want to buy a watch? Great. You want to buy this? Great. You want to do that? Great. But it shouldn't consume you. It shouldn't be like a worship tool. Just because you need money? Great. But that shouldn't make you worship it. Seriously, think about that. Okay, great. You can't pay your bills or you can't do this. But what's the deal? Hey, think about this. What do you need? Have you ever thought if you went homeless, how could you survive? I would dumpster dive if I had to. I'd be like waiting out there with bolt cutters outside the McDonald's and be grabbing burgers. Hey, people can say, oh, well, you're insulting. No, no, no. I'm just saying that you got to do what you got to do to survive, right? You got to do what you got to do. Because if you're not free, what are you? If you're not free, what are you? You're a slave. So those first two, that's why these top five commandments are more important than the bottom five. Case in point, you should not use the Lord's name in vain. So people think, well, if you say like, God dang it, or all that stuff, right? Well, it's much more than that. Using the Lord's name in vain, like cussing at God or saying God doesn't exist, right there. You're already insulting God. The third commandment should be more like insulting God. Right there, you're insulting God. You're using God's name in vain. You're talking bad about God. I don't think so. Number four, remember Sabbath day to be holy. This is huge. This violating Shabbat is worse than murder, people. You can say, oh, that's not right. Well, it's not your rule, is it? It's not your call, is it? It's God's call. God says it's more important, so it's more important. And we aren't remembering Shabbat. We're not honoring it. What's the problem? It's right there. That's why they tore it down in a lot of places, because they want us to be confused. Let's stop being confused. I don't think so. I'm honoring Shabbat. Number five, honor your parents, mother thy father. Wow. Why is that important? Why is that more important than murder? It is. God says it is. It is. Because your parents are your teachers. They're your doctors. They're your lawyers. They're your therapists. They're the people who give you guidance. And parents, you don't get a free pass just because you're a mother or a father. You've got to do your job too. It works both ways. The door works both ways. Now, we go to number six, thou shalt not murder. All of a sudden, this word is really starting to take off. Again, Ten Commandments. Don't forget, when people tell you stuff, I don't think so. Because here you go, the Ten Commandments. Number six, thou shalt not murder. All of a sudden, I'm hearing stuff about some laws in the East Coast about killing kids before, something about birth or something. I know we're not supposed to talk about this kind of stuff, but man, you gotta ball up, man. You gotta ball up. Gotta ball up. I won't even kill a spider. Let alone, well, I don't care how you diagnose it. Because we could sit there and diagnose it any other way. They did that same crap in Egypt. We're gonna kill all male Hebrew kids, and I'm sure they kind of came up with some kind of law, and everybody's like, oh, okay, nah, I'm not even gonna buy into that. No, not even close. Nope, not gonna buy into it. Thou shalt not murder. There you go. Pretty blunt. It's cut and dry. Don't look into it too much. Don't try to dissect it. It's cut and dry. Thou shalt not murder. Thou shalt not commit adultery. This is very simple stuff. If you violate it, if you don't believe it, that's your problem. I don't think so. There you go. Don't listen to what everybody says. Listen to these Ten Commandments. These are important stuff. God went out of his or her way, whatever way you want to go, God went out of God's way to create these commandments for us. Actually, there are 613 if you want to be exact, but 10 sums it up. Thou shall not commit adultery. Don't do it. Don't commit adultery. There's a variety of different things of what that means. Just think about it. I'm not going to do a huge lesson on it tonight, but I'm just going to just give you the basis of what I'm saying. I don't think so. Because when people want to try to tell me other than, I don't think so. When people say God doesn't exist, and yet they're passing laws about killing kids, I don't think so. I'm not going to listen to you anymore. If you say God doesn't exist, or I can't say God's name, or in the Pledge of Allegiance, then I don't think I'm going to believe anything you say. Because you can't take God away from me. You could try, but it ain't going to happen. It ain't going to happen. So number seven. Wait, that's number eight. Sorry. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not steal. There's all kinds of things you can dissect with it. Thou shalt not steal. Steal the truth. How about that? Steal the truth away from me. The truth. Wow. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not steal. There's a lot of things dissected, but thou shalt not steal. None of this stuff is okay. There is no variation. It's cut and dry. God made it very cut and dry, but God also made it very large in scale. Thou shalt not steal. It's not just like stealing someone's money. It could be much more than that. Stealing someone's girlfriend or husband or boyfriend or wife. It could be a lot of different things. Number nine. Thou shalt not lie. Thou shalt not bear false testimony. Lying. Truth. Lying. Well, I'm starting to see a lot of this lately. Do people even know what the truth is? I don't think so. See? Now you start to get the message. I don't think so. That's the platform. Do people even know what tell the truth is anymore? I don't think so. We need a refresher. We need a crash course. That's why we're doing the special edition. And number 10, thou shalt not covet. Don't be jealous. Why are we all jealous of each other all of a sudden? Who cares that you made this money? Who cares that you sold this? I always say this all the time, teachers, when I was growing up, mind your own business. It's that simple. I watched a video yesterday. This guy punched out two women, right? And it's like blowing up viral. I'm not a cop anymore. But my first question was this. You have all of these people watching. What are you doing? What are you doing? Why aren't you putting your damn cell phone down and helping out? There you go. That simple. We want this, but we're not going to willing to do that. I don't think so. I don't think it works that way. Step up. Step up. Take your chances. You spend 10 years over there doing Krav Maga, then do something about it. You're doing martial arts, you're doing boxing, then go help out another citizen. What are you doing filming? Put the damn phone down. Why is everything so bass-ackwards? It's not that challenging. Someone needs help, you go help them. You see someone on the side of the road in a snowstorm, don't drive by in a high speed and smash your snow tires into them so they get wet. Go help them out and say, can I give you a lift? Can I give you a jack? Can I help you out? Can I pump up your tire? What the circumstances? No, everybody's so scared. But yet we make judgments. The Ten Commandments will revamp our lives. It'll get us back to the basics. It'll get us back to what we need to do. And stop believing everything we read. Everything we read. Oh, we go to Google. Well, Google's computer. Not always right. People are like, oh, I bet you I crossed a line there. I didn't cross the line because it could be altered. It sure can. And if you think I'm lying, it can't. God exists way more than Google does. When I mean that Google doesn't exist, because Google exists, sure. But it can be altered. It can be tampered. God cannot. You cannot alter God. God will take a bribe. God cannot be hacked. Nope. God is smarter than all of us. That's why I follow God so much, because God is so advanced. We aren't. We think we are. No, we're not. Why? Because we are so way off from the Ten Commandments. So I don't think so. That's our platform. I love you all so much. Have a wonderful Shabbat. I hope I fulfilled what you guys wanted me to do tonight. I hope I pulled off the gloves enough to make a little difference. But the Ten Commandments, people, go to Deuteronomy. You can check it out for Christians. You can even go on to the New Testament and look it out. But the Ten Commandments are super important. Follow it. It is your guide. And dissect it yourself. Why is it that murder is less important than Shabbat? Think about that. Why? Why is honoring your parents more important than murder? There you go. That's the question. That's your homework. Think about it. Get back to me. I'll talk to you all Monday. I love you all so much. Special edition. God bless. Laila Tov. Help others be nice. Mwah. Have a wonderful weekend, everyone. I love y'all. And we'll end with a little traveling music. Just can't sleep at night. My bed is wet, don't know how.